I found this set of data in my records. These are duplicate blood alcohol samples from suspected drunken drivers, defendant's name, lab accession number, alcohol 1, alcohol 2. The samples are run in duplicate, as is often the case in analytical chemistry. Let's move forward in the way that many administrators do and take this data and quickly put it into an Excel spreadsheet where it's useful and easier to read. So now we have the defendant's name, analysis 1, analysis 2, defendant's name, analysis 1, analysis 2. Notice how the sample has been run twice, but the results don't come out the same every time. Analytical chemistry analysis produces errors, and we can see the errors in the duplicate analysis. You run it twice, you're not going to get the same answer. They should be close, but they're not going to be the same. How do we look at the errors? The standard approach is to look at the controls, run controls, look at the spread of the controls, and that will tell you what the errors are. But you can see the errors right in the duplicates. So let's add another column and call that column the delta, which would be the difference between the first one and the second one, at the absolute difference. And then let's make a column. This actually has a label, relative percent difference. Divide the difference by the absolute amount, and this will give us a percent variation in the duplicates. And we could average the percent variations and for this analysis get a good evaluation of the errors just from this. So we're looking at this approach using the duplicates and thinking, wait a minute, we could use this to compare, for example, one analyte with different techniques. We want to compare the techniques, or we could use this approach, let's say, for different matrices. Say you're looking for acetaminophen in urine and you're looking for acetaminophen in blood. How does the analysis compare by matrix? One of the presumptions in analytical chemistry is that the errors are independent of the quantitation. Well, use the duplicates to find out if that's actually true or not. So the group was real excited about this as a tool for us to have a better handle of where our errors are and what we're doing. In many analytical environments, duplicates are this regular procedure, is to run duplicates. And so we're all excited about this. We show this to the statistician in the group, and she kind of smiles and tries not to be too patronizing. But she says that if you want to use this approach, you really need to use this formula, which is the sum of the differences divided by 2 times the number of numbers, and then the square root of that will actually give you a standard deviation. And I think this is a powerful tool for the evaluation of data. This will never replace a control in analytical chemistry, but the duplicates are run as a standard procedure in many environments, and by looking at the duplicates, you can get another evaluation of what the errors are.